Bueno, ¿qué ha habido? Le vamos a dar la bienvenida a todos los chicos. Y a toda la banda de Kiwi Clark, que está Steven Adler acá.
Okay, guys.
Están andando en moto en este momento.
Welcome, everybody. Enjoy your lunch.
This is the best chicken we've ever had. And we think it's chicken.
This is a classic. It's been around for over 30 years.
I like these little potato chips. Fried. Let me know to eat anything. I have no idea.
Did I say that out loud?
Yes, you did. You said across the airwaves, across the, all of Argentina.
Vaya, unas chicas van a subir un rato a verlo
cuando toque.
And also, I picked out some really cool CDs to play some songs too. But, I get to take over the radio. I hear my voice and take over.
Va a pasar música en radio, Tim Adler.
To be our DJ.
Va a pasar música a todos los chicos y aparte van a tocar, van a hacer algo raro. Tenemos al primer oyente en línea, un tal Gilby Clark, está en el teléfono. Cayo, todo tuyo.
Radio.
Yeah, Gilby, what's going on?
Hey, is this Claudio?
Yeah.
Hey, Claudio.
Right, I'm here with Pablo Valente.
And I'm hanging out with all the guys.
Oh, yeah, Papa's there, right?
No, Papa's not here. We lost him.
Probably got tired of motorcycles and probably back at his place.
Exactly. Taking a nap.
So what are you guys doing?
We're having Argentinian barbecue. Went for a long motorcycle ride. We're having a barbecue, then we're going to ride back.
Bueno, que la banda directamente está comiendo acá un clásico que es Argentina, que es pollo. Después vamos a comparar cuando él venga, vamos a hacer una comparación entre todos, a ver quién comió mejor, que eso se va a demostrar al momento de tocar.
We're having some chicken here, which is really good. Yeah. And this guy's trying to make a comparison through what you guys are eating and us. So let's see who's got the best choice, all right? And
okay.
We'll see that tonight.
Okay. I think I got the best choice. I'm having beef.
I think so too, because you're having a barbecue and this is all grilled, so.
Yeah, see?
Va a llegar para tocar un rato.
Are you going to be here for the radio station?
Yeah, are we going to go back to the radio?
Yeah. Yeah, but not to play.
Okay, as soon as we're done with dessert, we're coming.
Okay, we'll be waiting for you.
Okay, we'll see you in a few.
Take care.
Okay, bye.
Bueno, esto pasó ayer a la noche en el Roxy.
Heavy metal!
Así que esto es un adelanto de lo que va a pasar hoy a la noche en el teatro. Kill Me ayer a la noche en el Roxy, un adelanto lo que va a hacer hoy a la noche en el teatro. Muy bien, muy bien.
We had no idea. We had no idea we were that good.
¿Qué sienten cuando...
We all want raises. We all want...
¿Les molesta escucharse en vivo? ¿Son de buscarse los defectos que tienen o...?
Do you like to listen to yourselves, like, after a gig? And...
I just like to look at myself, I think.
I like to look at myself.
There's a lot of times, I think there's a lot of times that I don't like to listen to myself, but just hearing it just now, I really got to give credit to the fans, because they gave so much energy last night,
yeah,
that I think it made us play a little bit.
I played so hard. The fans were so great. I got 5 new blisters. Hi, Melanie. How are you, darling?
I know you guys have probably heard it as like 1,000 times, the Argentinian fans, but, I mean, American bands coming over, you really are the best fans in the world.
Sé que lo escucharon miles de veces. Ustedes acá en Argentina son realmente, probablemente...
It's true.
Thank you, Argentina. Sienten, en verdad, y más como dicen, hoy por ahí en el teatro tienen una pequeña distancia con la gente porque hay un vallado, es más grande, más abierto. Sí. Pero en el Roxy... Hasta por el calor del lugar, por lo chiquito del lugar, por lo apretado.
Porque llueve.
Porque llueve transpiración, que sí. Es una lluvia media loca, pero llueve. Sí. Y está bárbaro igual. Y tiene que ver con eso también. ¿Siente que la gente lo empuja contra el escenario?
So, yesterday we played in a small club, which is like the Roxy, really close to the people. And tonight we're going to be playing like in a bigger place. We're going to have like a better gap with the audience. And it's going to be like really cool because what kind of places do you like to play?
I think being able to play both places is actually good for us. I think that the closer, more intimate places, you get to smell it. And they actually get the spit actually gets to hit you.
Right.
I think the smaller places.
The place we played last night, it was sweating on us.
Yeah.
Well, I already said
at the larger places, it's a little harder for the spit to actually make the stage. But I know it gives everybody a good you know, competitive trying.
Yeah.
Avisemos a la gente que no escupa hoy a la noche. Ya pedimos, por favor, que no escupieran.
Sí, por favor.
Pila. No,
sí.
No quedemos en el año 78.
Aprendan a no escupir. No existe. A nadie le gusta, en realidad.
Pero así. ¿Cómo mierda hace para tocar tan rápido, tan bien y con feeling? Cosa que hay muchos violeros muy rápidos. Que son rápidos nada más.
So how do you do that? How did you get to do that?
We're very emotional people.
Pretty much,
like,
yeah.
Emotional roller coaster.
Emotionally bound. Yeah, without sounding so corny, I really think that if you really play live, the audience feeds through you, and then it goes through your hands.
Porque no pasa con muchos guitarristas, o sea que hay muchos que son muy rápidos y solamente se quedan en ser rápidos.
Well, a lot of guitar players that I look up to and play both have a blues style bass also, like Papo. But the guys that I really grew up listening to, Brian May, best guitar player in the world, you know, one of the best, Randy Rhoads, guys that could play with feeling.
Lo que se siente es como que te envuelven a la hora de tocar, como que la nota no se va, sino como que el tipo te está agarrando.
Look, I would never compare myself to any of those guys because they're so far up from me, so happy to play their songs.
Bueno, vamos a la primera canción que eligió Steven.
Okay, Steven, you picked a song already?
Yeah, Queen song.
Oh, good choice. There it is.
¿Por qué Queen?
I love Queen. Roger Taylor, I grew up with Roger Taylor as my influence. Freddie Mercury was the I can think of as God.
Oh.
Don't stop me now.
What are you thinking about?
Froteurismo.
¿Dónde está Caio? Ahí está Caio. Bueno, Steven eligió otra vez música.
So you picked some stuff. Yeah, oh, see, yeah, I picked a few more things. I'm going to play Reckless Life. I wanted him to play next. I always loved that song. But I wanted to apologize about last night when we were playing Sweet Child of Mine. In the middle of the song, my bass pedal broke. That's what was messing me up. I'm so sorry. I wanted to stop and play it again, but in rock and roll, you can't stop.
No le da cosa a veces elegir, en este caso, que él elige un tema de los Guns N' Roses, ¿no? De Lice. Siente él, a través del tiempo, han pasado 15 años de este disco más o menos, que es parte de esa banda, o lo toma ya como un disco de la historia, o sea.
So now you're asking for a song from Lies, right?
Yes.
And it's like, how does it feel? It's been like 15, like over 17 years maybe.
Yeah, long time.
And like, what do you feel?
Well, I never thought the songs were that great, you know, because I was playing them. I can't hear. I have a different view and sound of what's going on in the song. But when I start, I didn't listen to the records for like about 5 or 6 years after I left the band. And then I got some bootleg videos and I was watching the shows and they're definitely great songs. I love playing them still. I like to get, you know, the four other assholes that, who are involved in making those songs together again. But I really think it's up to the fans to like email or write to, you know, Axel and Slash themselves to get their heads out of their ass. Start sending them letters, right?
Que no volvería a ser en los Guns N' Roses. What wouldn't you do in Guns N' Roses again if there would be a reunion?
Actually, I would love to record all the drums on Use Your Illusion over the way they were supposed to be played. The guy just played my demos. He played my versions. Yeah, I played Civil War was the last song I recorded with them.
¿Recibió algo de dinero?
Did you get any cash from it?
No, not from the Civil War.
Any of the Guns N' Roses? Any of
the everything. Oh, yeah, I got 15% of everything. I don't think it amounts to 5%.
Vamos a poner algo de Guns N' Roses.
Okay, we're gonna listen to some Lies, all right?
All right.
I was getting tired of boring bands.
He visto un arma mucho más poderosa.
We have seen a more powerful weapon.
Tenemos un llamado 4535 Rock, decir que algunos oyentes van a hacerle alguna pregunta.
We have some members of the audience, so they're listeners, they're going to be asking some questions for you guys.
Okay. Así que, hola, ¿quién está en línea? Hola. Hola.
Hola.
Sí, ¿quién está por ahí?
Sí, ¿qué tal? Mira, mi nombre es Guillermo.
¿Qué haces, Guillermo?
¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo te va? Un gusto primero por hablar con esos capos que tenés al lado.
Sí.
Bueno, mira, yo soy baterista, tengo mi banda, se llama Mendigo del Paraíso.
Sí.
Ese soy el batero del chico que tocó ayer con ellos, Gustavo.
Sí, sí.
Quisiera saber la opinión, no sé si ellos están contentos de que nosotros estamos haciendo un tributo acá en Argentina y bueno.
This guy who's calling, this very guy, is the drummer from the guy who sang last night with you. He wants to know your opinion. They're doing a tribute thing, so he wants to know what you think of the singer.
I thought that the singer did a really great job last night. He definitely helped me get through the songs.
Una cosa es el tono de voz, una cosa es la forma de cantar, que me parece bárbaro que uno pueda sacarlo. Yo no estoy de acuerdo cuando se mueven igual.
As you have played with Axel before, and you know how he does it and stuff.
Axel.
He wants to know what do you feel like when you see the guy moving like Axel?
The only person I've heard sound like that. We pulled it off.
Lo que pasa es que acá, obviamente Guns N' Roses y Axel Rose son únicos. Acá.
Sí, lo que yo igual quiero destacar que a mí me encanta que así como vino Steven o vienen los otros chicos. Cuando uno tiene un determinado ídolo, una forma de cantar que quiere parecerse, me parece bárbaro que pueda parecerse, pero yo nunca estoy de acuerdo es que pierdan la identidad como cantante, que una cosa que te parezca en el tono de voz, que me parece increíble que lo pueda sacar, y es más, Axel tiene un tono muy particular.
Right. To him, it's like the guy's losing personality if he's trying to like actually act like the guy.
Oh yeah.
Well, if anything, it just proves that there is only one Axl Rose and there is only one Steven Adler.
Yeah. 4535-7625, 4535 Rock. Bueno, aquí está en línea.
Hola.
Sí, ¿quién habla?
Diana.
¿Qué haces, Diana?
Soy Blancán.
¿Cómo te va?
¿Estoy al aire?
Estás al aire.
Sí. Quería preguntarle a Gilby.
No está Gilby.
Está
con una moto.
Steven.
Está Steven. Sí. Está Ryan.
Está toda la banda menos.
Está toda la banda menos Gilby.
Bueno, ¿le puedo hablar a Steven?
Sí, cómo no, dale.
Sí, hola, te quería decir que sos mi...
No empecemos con eso, no empecemos con la burguesa de te quiero, sos lo más lindo del mundo.
Sí,
Steven ya sabe que es lindo, ya sabe que es el mejor de todos. Vamos a decirle algo que Steven no sepa.
¿Me puedes mandar un saludo a él?
Thank you. I'm sorry, John. I don't have the headphones on, but thanks.
Le decimos que en este momento ella se está tocando a Steven.
¿Eh?
Oh, no way.
Ahora mandale un beso a tu mujer de nuevo. Decirle que le mande un beso a su mujer de nuevo.
That's okay. Para que lo quiera escuchar.
So is Steven.
Vamos a ver. They're trying to kill me.
I'm gonna go now.
Si vuelvas hoy a la noche, va a haber un tratamiento especial. ¿Vas a ir al teatro?
Sí.
Ok, te espera ahí.
Bueno.
Vamos a sacar el último llamado, le vamos a pedir eso. El que tiene la oportunidad de hacerle alguna pregunta, así que háganle preguntas
copadas. Claro, háganle preguntas copadas.
Hola, ¿quién está en línea?
Hola.
Hola, sí, ¿quién habla?
¿Qué tal? Hola, Cristian.
¿Qué haces, Cristian?
¿Cómo andas? ¿Todo bien?
Muy bien.
Le quería hacer una preguntita a Steven.
Dale, cómo no. Sí.
Hi, Steven. You see the version of Civil War in Use Your Illusion 2, in the credits is your number, like you recorded that song.
Yes, I recorded, that was the last song I recorded with those guys.
Para que lo que estamos en otro lado, hay 200.000 personas que no tienen la menor idea de inglés. Y vos ahí
me está preguntando por el disco Civil War y él le dice que sí. Que...
Claro, porque decían que ese tema lo había grabado de partes por partes, estaba medio cortado porque él faltaba siempre a las grabaciones.
Because they were saying that you wouldn't show to the sessions and they just recorded it in parts or something.
No. I was very sick when the Slash called me up and said we're going to record the song. I said wait a couple weeks. They said no. So it took me about 25 takes.
Ooh.
And I was just so sick and so weak that I my timing was... Yeah, they had to record on that.
Civil War?
Yeah.
That's my favorite track on the record.
Yeah.
Decirle a Ryan que el jueves anoche me dio la púa.
You gave me a pick.
Ah, hey.
¿Y en qué parte del escenario se pone? Porque
use it well.
What side of the stage are you be on? Like left or right? Because he wants to get closer to...
I will be on both, yeah.
Está bien.
Un abrazo grande.
Bueno, gracias, che.
Bueno, ¿quién eligió Van Halen? Mike, me parece que eligió Van Halen.
Who picked Van Halen here?
Van Halen Spaz.
¿Por qué Van Halen?
Primary.
Why Van Halen?
That's what I grew up on.
I love Van Halen.
Speaking to the mic.
That's what I grew up on, playing the drums too. I was learning to those songs.
Con David Lee Roth, con Sammy Hagar es otra banda.
Diamond Day.
Yeah, that's the real Van Halen, not just like GNR, it was the real GNR with Steven.
Beatles had Ringo Starr, Guns N' Roses had Steven.
Es el primer disco de Van Halen.
I think they were the same.
It's from the very first album.
My favorite one, just like GNR.
Bueno, para mí, gracias, guys.
Nada fue igual después de ese primer disco de Van Halen en lo que es rock and roll.
Do you feel the love in this room, or can you at least smell it?
I can smell the finger. Okay, boy.
Welcome, Van Halen. Viene de una carrera de motos loca, de un asado endemoniado también. Están como distendidos hoy, ¿no? Caído, están así como tranquilos.
You're kind of laid back today.
He's a motorcycle cowboy. What do you want?
My new brothers. Yeah, your face is like, yeah, like the shape of dirt. A lot of dirt there.
Have you ever ridden a motorcycle on your freeways?
It's incredible, man.
You got a lot of guts.
You don't need a helmet.
There's no unleaded gas.
There's nothing like riding through, you know, with the wind in your hair, your old lady hanging on for dear life. It was great.
Bienvenido.
Well, first of all, welcome.
I think it's at a limit para que algo lo movilice.
Do you need to get to the limit so something drives you?
No, I'm not like that.
No,
I just take everything one day at a time. I don't know.
I get here and all the fun's over and everybody starts laughing. The boss is here.
You got teenage girls.
You guys better pump it up. I'll bring my gang in here.
Your motorcycle gang.
Exactly. ¿Qué hacen tu tiempo libre? Sabemos por lo menos las motos les gustan mucho. Tiene que ver con eso, con motos.
So what are you doing? You're free. free time, we know you like motorcycles. Yeah. So what's a day like, Gilby Clark?
My day, I'm locked up in a studio 24 hours.
Estoy encerrado en un estudio 24 horas por día.
I am.
Entendemos por qué la banda se puso seria.
So that's why we get it. Yeah. That's why they got serious, you know.
And sometimes we take a break, we go for a swim.
¿Qué te llamó la atención del show de ayer a la noche?
What did you like the best about last night?
You know what? I love it when they sing our songs back to us. I always, I really enjoy playing Cure Me or Kill Me here. I like when they sing the riff.
Oh, really?
Play it over the air. Yeah. Sounded good.
Recién lo estuvimos escuchando y suena bueno.
I gotta watch what we're playing then.
It's been released.
We're dropped already.
You're gonna get copies anyway.
Okay, gracias.
Vamos a pasar otro tema más del ayer.
We're gonna play you another song from yesterday.
Okay.
Sweet Child of Mine. No, please. No. No, please.
Listo.
Flowers.
Oh, that was a good one.
Nos están llegando algunos mails. La gente le encanta cómo suena la banda. Es una muy compacta.
We're getting mails. People really like the band. And they're asking who's singing.
that's the one they want to kill, huh? I never said I was a singer. I said I was a guitar player.
Bueno, están leyendo unos mails que mandaron, pero estamos en papelitos acá porque no nos anda el monitor. What do you do in your free time when you're home?
I don't have free time. I spend all my time in Red Room Studio.
I work all the time.
Papo es un músico reconocido en Argentina. Tiene algunos amigos o gente con que ha tocado como B.B. King que lo han llevado de gira en todos sus shows. ¿Qué le puede aportar Papo como que ayer subió con Gilby Clark?
As you might know, Papo is a well-known guy here in Argentina. Yes. He was actually invited by B.B. King to play live with him. And what did he give you?
I was actually amazed how well he fit into the band. I don't even know if he knew the songs we were playing, but he fit in perfectly as if he was the other guitar player in the band. Right. You know, people could learn a lot from Papo. That's not easy to do, to walk into a strange situation and just play, and he played perfect.
Esos son violeros. ¿Qué nos deslumbra de un guitarrista a esta altura?
You guys that are guitar players, what is it that you really like about a guitar player, any guitar player?
I like people that play their own style, have their own thing. They can pick up any guitar, any amp, and they sound like them.
And what about Ryan?
It takes a while, I think, for any guitar player to come up with their own style, but I think if you listen to enough guitar players, enough great guitar players and your influence, and then you don't just copy them, but you take all those influences and make it your own, that's what makes a great guitar.
Hacen canciones de bandas clásicas como T-Rex, como Alice Cooper, como Los Ramones, como Iggy Pop. ¿Piensan que en algunos años algunas bandas van a hacer temas de ellos?
To play Rolling Stones, Alice Cooper, a bunch of songs. Do you think that people in the future are going to be like playing your stuff?
I hope so. It's about 20 years.
And you're not going to get paid for that.
No. Because we're not paying them.
Unfortunately, there was a little band called the Beatles. And there's never going to be a better band. So 100 years from now, 1,000 years from now.
¿Por qué no importa la edad del músico? Todos ponen Rolling Stones, Beatles o T-Rex como las bandas creadoras de lo que es el hard rock.
¿Por qué no importa la edad?
Porque no importa la edad del músico, pero siempre el músico dice, estas son las tres bandas.
It doesn't really matter how old musicians are, they always know the Beatles, Stones, T-Rex, maybe the Kinks, they're like biggest bands. Yeah. It's like, why do you think this is?
I think because songs. You just never forget those songs. And back then, when a band was together, it was four or five guys trying to make a song great. I think there's too much individualism these days. You know, guys like me, solo artists. But the industry won't let you have a band now.
That's true.
Cuando él empezó, por lo menos, cuando él saltó a la fama con Guns N' Roses, las compañías actúan de una manera con las bandas. En este momento, para las bandas son números. Pero si venden o no venden, exportan un carajo como que hagan con su música.
Companies treat you like you're a number and that's it.
Yeah.
And, what's your opinion about all that? When you started with Guns N' Roses, there was something going on and then...
That's a unique situation and I think that doesn't, you can tell, it doesn't happen that often. A record label won't let you have that creativity to spend the time to develop your band and develop your songs. Yeah, if you don't have a hit the first time out, you're gone.
And if there are any record companies out there that would put the money into development, I'd like their number.
En algún momento pensaron, buscaron desesperadamente componer un hit
O sea, esa cosa de quiero componer un hit
o sale naturalmente. Have you ever thought of, really want this song to be a hit? And it's like, did you really work hard for hits? Or did they just come out like naturally?
Our job is to write, record, and perform the songs. That is really up to a record company. A record company can make any song a hit if they want.
So it's all up to the company, basically.
Always. Yeah. Records buy, you buy a hit record.
Muchas gracias por haber venido. Que esperemos que hoy tengan la noche en el teatro un show de puta madre como fue el de ayer.
Thank you guys for coming over. We hope you kick ass tonight.
Pueden conseguir todavía entradas la gente para comprar y verlos a los chicos hoy a la noche. Chino, ¿dónde? Las entradas. 20 pesos. Hubo un descuento de 5 mangos las entradas. Así. Incluye el show de ayer.
Let's thank Mariano for the bike.
Así que hoy pueden comprar las entradas en el teatro. En Federico La Cosa y Álvarez Tomás tienen tiempo para hasta el momento del show. Ellos van a tocar bastante tarde. Van a empezar las bandas soportes a las 9, 10 de la noche. Así que tienen hasta la 1 de la mañana para empezar a tocar Gary Clark. Compren las entradas, vayan a verlo. Y vamos con el último tema, uno de los que tocaron ayer, donde demostraron que Argentina ahora es un país civilizado y dejan cantar a Caio. Come Together de los Beatles ayer.
They're going to play the song you guys invited me to play. So.
Oh, okay.
Is that before or after you got mugged?
I just want to check me out right now.
Give it up for Claudio on vocals, come on.